Greetings, guys and girls, fellow gamers. My name is GameStoreKicks, and welcome to the 100th episode of this playlist. You guys were asking me to do something just to celebrate, I suppose, the 100th episode. To be fair, it is about the 800th episode. I have over 1,200 videos on YouTube since September 2014 uploaded, and most of them are 7 Days to Die. But a few of you are asking, so I said on very short notice to myself, I decided, okay, fine, you know what, let's do a little bit, just have a little bit of a laugh. It's in a test world. I tried to do some things that I tested out in this test world to do it in the real world, but it all ended up in disaster. So I can tell you about it later on when we do the actual work in our real world. But anyway, welcome to the 100th episode, and we want to have some fun with TNT. TNT is a very delicate process. I tried a few things, but they all ended in tears. So let's see what happens with this. We want to get a good view of this, possibly a nice eagle eye view of this. Maybe, I think, and hopefully it doesn't go completely to shit. But let's just see how it works. The frames are gonna dip like mental now. I'm gonna tell you this right now. The frames are going to drop, but we should survive. We should not have a crash. Okay, let's go. Come on. Oh, it's working. Look at all these blocks. That's like a gazillion blocks. And we're at the house. Boom, boom, boom! Look at this going around the house! It's walking around the block! Oh my god, we had 2 frames per second! Oh my god, and the graphics, it just had to stop updating. Look at this, it just, in the end, stopped exploding and just updated. This house has no more ground floor. This is... Look at this! I can see someone sitting there on the shitter going like, was that me? Oh, like, I knew I had a bad curry last night, but holy balls, this is really bad. I'm sorry. That would be me sitting on, you know, like you see in the comedy movies, like when the whole house falls apart and the guy sits on the toilet going, what? Oh man, this house is history. And look, we even got floating blocks and oh, here they go. They finally broke down. Very nice. Anyway, welcome to the UU episode. Look at this trench, holy balls. Yes, if you want to build a wall with pillars, and this is the problems I had, yeah? If you have pillars actually here, right here at the edge, they all get destroyed, yeah? No matter what I tried to get distances, whatever. But I would say if you're doing from scratch before you build a wall with pillars, absolutely. Dig this trench with TNT. It is so much fun. Look at this. Anyway, I'm gonna see you guys in the game. This was fun. It was nothing too special, but a little something. Anyway, see you guys in a second. Okay, we're back in our real world, and just really quickly, I know a few of you don't like when I explain things, but just really quickly, the reason I didn't do it in the real world is I replicated this wall, as I said already in the last world, and you have to basically, up to 3 high, I think even 4 high, put wood frames everywhere. Yeah, and you're gonna have to put your TNT about here. If you put your TNT here, it only blasts a hole up to here. But if you want the hole, the 1 block deep hole here, you're gonna have to place the TNT here. The problem is it's too close to the wall, so it actually will blast away the pillars as well. It won't make a hole underneath the pillar, but it will blast it away. So to dampen the explosion, you're gonna put these wood frames here. Okay, and then you also have to be careful because the explosion wraps about around in a kind of diamond shape. So you have to put it to about, I would say, here. Yeah, and then your last pillar is safe as well. And then you have to place them every third one or so because you have to individually shoot them. If you place them too close and the chain explode, what happens is this one explodes, removes the wood frames, this one explodes, and it removes the pillars. So you have to be very careful how you're going to organize that. You're going to have to set them at least, I think, even 3 spaces in between apart, and then shoot them individually. Now, the problem is if you already have a wall, it's gonna leave a mess. You have debris flying around, possibly even breaking the pillars anyway, or breaking the trussing on top, breaking the house, breaking the iron bars, breaking the fences. Debris will kill everything, especially the wood debris. It will just destroy everything, yeah? And it's not worth it. But if you are building from scratch, and it's the first time, which I'm gonna do as well from now on, if I have the TNT, I will do the trench first, and then build my pillars along the trench afterwards. It saves me a lot of digging, and you guys are absolutely right. It's much quicker than digging down through stupid asphalt. Anyway, We're outside for a reason. We're going to start digging. Now, I'm not sure exactly how we're going to count that to get down to the same level as this. But I think what we're going to do is we're going to go over here. We're going to start digging the general direction. And once we are here, approximately here, and I think I can do it with the northwest south. You see the way your location is here. If I move forward now, this is 3277 south and 970 west. So if I'm walking one block over, you can see I'm at 368. If I'm walking, and that's me standing here. Now, if I'm walking onto this block, I'm gonna be at 368 still. Okay, a little bit more. 367. So what we're trying to do is we're gonna note this location here, yeah? We are gonna be here. I think if we stand on the edge, it's gonna be 368. And if we stand on the other edge, it's potentially already 369, yeah? So we want to be at exactly 368. And I'm gonna write that down because that's gonna become very important. I'm only showing you this because a few of you have asked how you do that, you know? So you take that, it's 968, dyslexic much, looking at the 3277. So 3277 and 968. Now the 3277 is obviously important for how far we have to go down, because as soon as we go here, it's gonna be at 3276. So let's go into our base, into our underground tunnel, and let's start digging. It's going to be a lot of work. This will be time-lapsed. This might even be a very long time-lapse. I'm going to try to cut out a lot of things in between, but nonetheless, this is probably going to be about 20 minutes to half an hour work. And I'm trying to condense that into segments to get about a 3.5-minute time-lapse done, just so you guys know. Again, it's not for to explain to you, it's just a few of you I have asked, actually, you know, like how much work is involved with that. So there you go, that's how much. So let's get a couple of more. Where did I put my tools? Here. So let's get another pickaxe going, and let's get some steel as well to craft new pickaxes as well. So let's make some forged steel. Let's make 25, because that's 5 steel axes. Yeah, excellent. And we're making water here as well, actually, to cure up some jars. I think more jars are always good. So let's make about, what do we have here? 15, 30, 60 jars. Excellent. Cured up. Brilliant. So I'm going to see you guys downstairs, and then we're going to start digging. It's just the way we see it, and I can't believe it. Oh, my, 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 my. Thank you. today, it is. Absolutely gorgeous. I had to sacrifice a little bit of farmland because it looked pretty shit just having dirt around it and then have this, because the way dirt flows, and I remember I said that before when we were working a couple of episodes ago on the other side over there, that dirt doesn't go flush. You can see it here. It doesn't go flush into solid blocks. And I really, really wish that's something that they can do. I mean, if you build a block on top of something, you see how it dents in. I really wish that if you place dirt or beside a block or block beside a dirt, that it would start filling in these little shitty gaps so that it looks like it's embedded in the dirt properly. Because the problem is, if you have dirt all around it, you can see basically all through it. And I really don't like the way that looks. It looks like the hatch is hovering in the air just about. It's kind of looking weird. So we had to sacrifice a little bit, but it is exactly where we wanted it to be. Now, in the end, the reason it took me so long to do the rest is because it got a little bit confusing in the end. I was looking here and it said 69, 68, 78. And so I decided then, when I was deep in far enough, said, screw that. I'm going to go to the top and come from the top to the bottom. So that worked out pretty well. So this is going to be the full width of it. Well, not really. This is going to be the full width. So we're going to have basically the entrance in the middle, which means we're going to have one extra lane here. Basically exactly what we did here. And I also used your tip with the plates. Yeah, the wood plates. I know it looks a little bit offset, but I can live with that. I really have no issue with that because it's nice and neat. It saves me digging an extra hole behind it. It's lovely. It's nice and clean, okay? And I can live with that little denty thing. Now, what we want to do here is, of course, the same thing. We want to go one deeper. So one space that this is exactly in the middle. And we're going to be digging all the way around it, of course. Oh, look at that. There's actually some nice little, whatchamacallit, iron all the way around it, which is really lovely. So let's just go here around it. Oh, look at that. Lovely. I'm not going to follow the vein and start digging randomly. And yes, that may be the German in me. I like order. I can't help it. I like order. I like to cause chaos, but I do appreciate order. Oh, this could be so misinterpreted in so many ways. Anyway, yes, so because this tunnel is obviously going to go further, it's going to go beyond, and we're going to have the mini bike down here as well that we can then use to drive around everywhere, and that's why I make it a little bit wider as well. So in the end of the day, what we're going to have is we have this here, one block over. There it was. There, like that. Nice. And I made a little bit of stone. There we go. Let's fill in the gaps again. There we go. Nice. And that means we have one lane free on either side. And it's going to be a three-block lane, which is wide enough for a minibike. And the minibike can get past this here as well, which is nice. And we can put two torches up as well. Here. And here. And actually, let me put it a bit higher. There we go. And I think this is the maximum height I want to give it, which should be nice. It should be enough. Again, we don't need a wood ceiling. We just basically leave the stone ceiling and have the wood go into it, which means this is how high it's going to be. And I'm, yeah, that's perfectly fine. Now, what we might actually do is we might, I don't know. I don't like the way this works and you can get stuck in it. So what I might actually do is make this all wood and this all wood all the way down and all the way here so that you have a nice perfect square tunnel. But anyway, that's besides the point. So we are going to finish soon. Let me just go along here a little bit more. There we go. Nice. Lovely. And this is what I meant by digging near the house where you want the shapes. Yeah, if I start digging this now, like I have some stone left, I dig this out to get the coal, or and you see it keeps going, and then you follow this, and in the end, because I like it clean, I have to cover it all up again, and it's just a waste of stone resources. So I'm just basically trying to refrain and hold back on following these veins when they're in something that I want to actually build around. So I don't know if that makes sense. I know it's a bit freaky maybe, but hey ho, so be it. So that is a nice ceiling. This, oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. We got a bit eager there, and That is it. This looks lovely. I mean, there's absolutely nothing wrong. Yeah, we're gonna have to fill in these holes as well, but this is perfect. There you go. I could do this forever now. You know yourself, when you once you start, you kind of go, oh yeah, just take this block out. Oh, I take this block out. Oh yeah, and what about this one? And you're just gonna start continuing, and 3 hours later, you're still digging. Anyway, let's go back to the kitchen area that we have underneath our little crack den, because there's another couple of things I want to do. And there we go. Look at this. Nice. I think this looks lovely. Let's actually finish the plates. Let's do another 10 plates. Oh, ugh. Not the number, you plank. Oh, can we not make 10? Oh, we have no wood. We upgraded everything. Yeah, I have more wood back then. Anyway, we leave this here. And we're just gonna put these guys probably here. There we go. Ah, no, don't even fit. Let's take a little bit more stone. We have still room for stone, yeah? 1,000, 1,000, 1,000, 1,000, 1,000. No, actually, we have probably stone lying around here that we can't pick up. Okay, let's go back. This is basically how far we dug. It is very, very lovely. We have loads of resources here that we dug through as well. And there we go. I kept it all simple in the beginning. And this is gonna lead us directly into our area, which is nice. Look at that. Lovely. Into our kitchen. Isn't that cool? And what you guys were saying about the kitchen, and I really like that idea actually. So what I would like to do is the kitchen floor area. This one here, I'm gonna take that out. Let's put all the stone away for now. There we go. Stone. We actually got a good bit of metal and also a little bit of sand. And then the metal here, which is not as much. And we have... Yep. We have that here, and then we put these guys here. There we go. Nice. Sweet! Might as well kick off another 1,000. Oh, we can't do that. Yeah, we have to do a workbench down here, actually. That would really be beneficial, I suppose. Recipe, gunpowder, craft. There we go. Okay, so what we do here in the kitchen, let me get my other tool, my steel axe. There we go. And let's take the floor out. So, this is the last one, and I've done that before. Remember back, if you're new to the channel, I did an episode way, way back where I refurbished a building, an apartment block in the city, and I made the whole bottom floor like a hotel entrance, like, you know, like a nice grand entrance. And, oh, look, I don't like that. That bothers me now, even though if that is going to be hidden. So we're going to put that with stone. Thank you very much. And we used basically the worktops, and one of you guys luckily reminded me of that and said, hey, you should use them. And I was like, oh, of course. So what you do is you would use these guys. Okay, there you go. And I know it says empty cabinets and all that, and that's the only downside, but we're not gonna be looking at the floor that often. Look at that. I think that looks absolutely nice. It looks really lovely because it has a nice shine of it. It actually bounces back the light and has a reflective surface, basically. And back in the, when I did the upgrade with the hotel, this looks nice. I like that. Look at this. It looks like a proper area now. It's really lovely. I personally like it, but again, it's up to personal taste. But thank you very much for reminding me, actually, of that. Also, I want to do one more thing. Let me... Actually, we already have that here. So let's take out... Oh! I'm not gonna run for it. I'm just gonna miss it anyway. So I don't really need them anyway. Well, I could have an auger recipe in it. Well, I have. I don't know. Anyway, we're gonna see if we can catch it. Let's just get this out, and let's get rid of this fireplace, and let's put this pot down. There you go. Nice. Now it looks like a proper kitchen. Anyway, let's rush upstairs and let's see if we can see that airdrop. I don't think we're going to be able to see it because it was right above us and we're very slow again. We're probably overheating. No, we're not actually. We're a good temperature. Let's see. I like this now that we can actually get out here. There we go. Where's the... Is it anywhere we can see it? It should probably be over there somewhere behind the trees, but I don't think we're going to be able to see it. So let's just get on top of the base quickly. I'm bleeding. Damn it. And medicine. There we go. Use... Yeah, it's probably gone by now. Definitely gone by now. Yeah, it's not there. Anyway, I'm going to leave this episode here. We're going to find these eventually, and I'm not really too fussed. We're going to find these guys again, and oh, look at these trees. It looks lovely. Our tree farm is coming along really, really nice. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, remember to kick that like button in the balls, and I hope to see you guys in another episode. And if you're new to the channel and you like what you see, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys next time. Until then, as always, viel Spaß and happy gaming. Woo! Boom! Nice. This is like lovely. Look at that. We're completely. And then we're going to connect the tunnel over there as well. And it's going to be awesome. And then we're going to get a bike entrance to it. And it's going to be even awesomer. It's going to be so much awesomer.